Today is Terrible Tax Tuesday with Jim Hiles at First Capital and Go Plan 101. We're going to talk today about solar credits, which is kind of an interesting one because as we move toward this green world we're hoping to get to in 5 years or so, we're going to take advantage of things like solar, which from a cost standpoint, the cost of solar energy and solar power have come down quite a bit. And there's actually a tax credit for this. So there's a federal residential solar energy tax credit that you can claim against your federal income taxes by putting in this type of solar system. So you have to put it in service during the tax year and generate electricity for the home in the United States. And this happened in December 2020 when Congress passed the extension of the investment tax credit, the ITC, which gives a 26% tax credit for systems installed in this year and through 2022, and a 22% tax credit for systems in 2023. There's no maximum amount on this, which makes it interesting. So what expenses are included? The solar panels and cells used to power an attic fan, but not the fan itself, for example. Contractor labor costs, it's on-site prep, assembly, installation, and so on. Balance of system equipment, wiring, inverters, energy storage devices associated with those solar panels. So you've got your batteries in there too. So you can claim it by getting out your tax form, 5695 in your federal tax return, and go ahead and complete the solar energy tax credit. It might be an interesting way to generate some tax savings in what could be an increasing tax rate environment. Although as of today, it looks like Senator Manchin might put the kibosh, at least for 2021, on what could happen with taxes. And we're hoping it doesn't happen in 2022. So we'll talk to you later. Jim Hiles signing off for now.